hello, everybody. Welcome back to Howling Moon Studios. In sunny Northern California, it's actually really very warm today, and it's as though we're at the back half of spring and getting ready for some summer. So yesterday was a really interesting experiment. We attempted to do the whole show on Zoom with the T-Sisters in the East Bay and us on the peninsula. And I think we can safely say that Zoom has some challenging technical issues for doing music. Namely, it's got a thing where it blocks really high pitches. And so when Chloe was playing the kazoo, it just took the volume way down and stuff like that. And you know, it's a live and learn kind of situation. Our next gig with the T's, we're going to go to we're basically going to use the Zoom only for the part where we talk to each other, but we're going to play the music over the system here that we're using right now. And today we're making a really big improvement in this system because we've got a mic. And we're using the mic so that both the spoken word and the vocals are much clearer, and also to just give it a little bit more ambiance so that it, you know, the issue of it coming over cell phones or computers is less of a problem. Anyway, today is a half duo show, and I'm here, and I'm gonna do all kinds of stuff. But I have a theme, and you know, I could make the theme a secret, but I want you to be able to enjoy the music and not spend too much time thinking about it. So it's about, loosely speaking, it's about transportation. And transportation is like one of those things right now, at least. I don't know about you, but today I finally got my battery recharged in my car because it had sat completely idle for almost a month because I hadn't left home. And I drove the car 5 miles down the street and back just to keep the battery from dying again. So that's the first time I've been away from my house for 4 weeks. And as a consequence, I think about the road. So here we go. Want to send this out to Timmy. And to Bert Keeley. The road to here from Baltimore had many twists and turns. No map to guide us on it, so few and far between. Memories in a rearview mirror, like boxcars in a train. Objects are much smaller than they seem. To hear from Davenport took us through the cold, black ice and white ice ruled the plains that day. Frigid winds screamed across the prairie like bad news. We stayed on coast and never lost our way. The road to here has had its share of potholes, stones, and dust. But monuments and vistas are what I remember most. The twists and turns don't faze me now the way they used to do. As long as I can share the road with you. From Baltimore to Davenport, from Anchorage to here, the road twists like a dancer on Benzedrine and Everclear. No
matter where you come from or who you are today, the road from here's a brand new game, so deal the cards and play. From Anchorage is the best we've ever known. Peaks of wonder and valleys under the skin of nature's song. Guided by the northern lights, we see the future now. A road that is both beautiful and long. The road to here has had its share of potholes, stones and dust, but monuments and vistas are what I remember most. The twists and turns don't faze me now the way they used to do, as long as I can share the road with you. The road to here has had its share of potholes, stones and dust, but monuments and vistas are what I remember most. The twists and turns don't faze me now the way they used to do, as long as I can share the road with you. As long as I can share the road with you.
So that song quite obviously is autobiographical. It really was one of those things that there was a moment in time when I was just sort of sitting there realizing, I've been some places. And a whole bunch of them had three syllables in them. And that made it really easy to make that song. Anyway, I didn't write this next one, but it's about transportation too.
Give me a ticket on an airplane. I ain't got time to take a fast train. Long days are gone, now I'm going home. My baby just wrote me a letter. I don't care how much money I gotta spend. Gotta get back to my baby again. Lonely days are gone, I'm going home. My baby just wrote me a letter. Well, she wrote me a letter, said she wanted to live without me no more. Listen, mister, can't you see? You gotta get back to my baby once more. Anyway, I don't care how much money I gotta spend.
I do not know how many of you are regular viewers of the White House 5 o'clock Follies, but yesterday, the man in charge, or at least the man who is at the top of the organization chart, made a recommendation that maybe we could all protect ourselves against COVID-19 by injecting Lysol or the equivalent kind of bleach, or perhaps by somehow irradiating our insides with sunlight. Now, I wrote this song about a different president and a different time, but it pretty much fits what we got going on here. It's called In My Dreams. In my dreams, I'm gonna build giant ocean liner. In my dreams, it will be like Titanic, only finer. In my dreams, the passengers will come from cable news and politics, blowhards and hypocrites, divide the country with their shticks, the network and the wingnuts, so anger and resentment. While five white souls in Washington roll back the Enlightenment, the speaker thinks it's peachy, the turtle thinks it's hot. They both claim to be Lincoln, but honest Abe, they're not. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Captain is that guy whose cruise ship ran aground. They say he's reborn, but he's nowhere to be found. I'll send the apprentice and the model, Tweedledum and Tweedledee, and their fashion-selling daughter and her preppy out to sea. And all the angry white folks with their statues and their swastikas, gun nuts and cyber trolls putting down the rest of us. Whoa, 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 whoa. The lookout is that guy from the Exxon Valdez. He'll be three sheets to the wind, even when there is no breeze. In my dreams, I'm gonna build a maritime disaster. In my dreams, it will sink like Titanic on them faster. In my dreams, they give out prizes for getting rid of bad guys. But my ship's not big enough for all the assholes and their big lies. In my dreams, I've got a second ship to carry all the overflow and several others in construction, 'cause the asshole population grows. In my dreams, in my dreams, in my dreams. Cruise ships in this current environment take on a whole new meaning. So if a month and a half ago, right after Super Tuesday, if you're paying close attention to Twitter, you might well have seen that I posted a song from our upcoming album. It was designed to honor somebody I really admire. And the thing you have to understand is that this song was really, I started it, but everybody in Full Moon Alice contributed, and so everybody is a part author of the song. And you have to imagine the T's singing, because they sing parts of the verse, they sing parts of the chorus, and they sing the entire outro. So this will be a pale imitation, but it is the first live performance of the song. So.
Thousands of people in Washington Square come out to be part of a dream where fairness and justice are not just for people like me. Hours in line for a selfie, pinky with each little girl, coming together to take back a vision gone wrong. Internet titans and Wall Street tycoons with money and power and greed, they have nothing we want anymore, nothing we want anymore. I want to follow her lead now, I'm drawn to the words of her song. Tell those patriarch bullies to pack up their bags, they've led us astray for too long. Put the woman in charge, please, it's time to try something new. There's nothing to fear, the future is here and it's ours if we make it true. Too many people for too many years denied the fruits of their dreams, stuck in a world that works just for people like me. Powerful villains with ego and greed and fantasies too sick for words, enabled by lawyers and buddies and money to burn. Their victims were scared into silence till a miracle finally occurred. Some villains are going to jail now, some villains are going to jail. I want to follow her lead now, I'm drawn to the words of her song. Tell those patriarch bullies to pack up their bags, they've led us astray for too long. Put the woman in charge, please, it's time to try something new. There's nothing to fear, the future is here and it's ours if we make it true. Millions of people all over the world protest a dangerous fool who favors a world that works just for people like him. Millions of voices beg to be heard, equality, fairness, and love. Values we once took for granted are melting away. Marching is just the beginning. From Hong Kong to San Juan to here, we cannot stand back anymore. We cannot stand back anymore. I want to follow her dream now, I'm drawn to the words of her song. Tell those patriarch bullies to pack up their bags, they've led us astray for too long. Tell the woman in charge, please, it's time to try something new. There's nothing to fear, the future is here and it's ours if we make it true.
Time has come.
go. That's called Follow Her. And I hope you like it. I mean, the album versions are many times better because everybody's on it, especially the T's. Some of you know I learned that arrangement from Jorma Kaukonen, who has been an inspiration to me my whole life and has been a guitar teacher. He's played with us. I mean, you know, if you had told me in 1970 or 71 when I first heard the very first Hot Tuna album that one day I would, you know, get to take classes from Jorma, like learn how to fingerstyle guitar and get to play some shows with him, I would have looked at you like you were from, well, someplace else. And, you know, as I look back at my life, there are few things in my life that make me more proud than having gotten the opportunity to do that and not screw it up. When we played the show at Lockin, which is an amazing festival in Virginia, when we were Jorma's backup band. So we played an entire set. Well, he played one of our songs followed by an entire set of Yorma's songs, and that was pretty epic. But playing at Fur Peace Ranch, which is Yorma's guitar camp, that's a spiritual place. That's like LaVon Helm's barn. I mean, it's like the Fillmore. It's like one of these places where, as a musician, when you get to play there, I'm sure Carnegie Hall's the same way, that it's like one of those things that you, bucket list kind of place. Anyway, Yorma's had a huge influence on me, and I'm a terrible fingerstyle guitar player, but nonetheless, I like his material so much that I've learned to play a few of them. So I'm going to play a couple more Yorma songs here.
As long as I'm in this world, I am the light of this world. Just as long as I'm in this world, I am the light of this world. You don't believe in Jesus, not one word he said. Go on down to Lazarus' grave, watch him rise from the dead. Just as long as I'm in this world, I am the light of this world. Just as long as I'm in this world, I am the light of this world. I've got fiery fingers, well, I've got fiery hands. If I gotta go up to heaven above, you know I'm playing that fiery band. Just as long as I'm in this world, I am the light of this world. Just as long as I'm in this world, I can't walk on water, well, I can't walk on air. But if I gotta walk on the kingdom come, you know I'm gonna make it there. Just as long as I'm in this world, I am the light of this world. Just as long as I'm in this world, I am the light of this world. Just as long as I'm in this world, I am the light of this world. Just as long as I'm in this world, I am the light of this world.
Always loved that song. You know, I'm not practicing anything, but you know, there are a lot of really great songs written, you know, in the name of various religions, and that is one. And you know, they can be great songs even if you don't subscribe. Baby, how long?
look down those tracks, feeling so bad. Just lost the best girl, babe, that I've ever had. Well, how now? And now, baby, how long? Well, how now? That evening train been gone, it's been gone since that blood red sun went down. Well, how long, baby, how long has that evening train been gone? It's been gone since that blood red sun went down.
You may have noticed that that song is about trains. And in our transportationally themed show today, the rest of the set, in fact, is going to be about trains. Because it turns out I know a lot of songs about trains, and this is not all of them. This is just the ones I haven't played lately. So there you go. Anyway, trains come in all shapes and sizes, and this one comes from the South.
She complicated, left me a mule to ride. She complicated, left me a mule to ride. She complicated, left me a mule to ride. The train left the station, pulled out behind. Well, I'm crazy about her, that hard-headed woman of mine. Baby, she's long, but good God Almighty, she's tall. Baby, she's long, good God Almighty, she's tall. My baby, she's long, my baby, she's tall. Sleep with her head on the pillow, her feet in the hall. I'm crazy about her, that hard-headed woman of mine. I love my baby, she's so fine. I wish she'd come and see me sometime. If you don't believe I love her, look at the hole I'm in. You don't believe I'm sinking, look at the fool I've been. She got the kitty, left me a mule to ride. She got the kitty, left me a mule to ride. She got the kitty, left me a mule to ride. The train left the station, I put him behind. When I'm crazy about her, that hard-headed woman of mine. I love my baby, she's so fine. I wish she'd come and see me sometime. You don't believe I love her, look at the fool I've been. You don't believe I love her, look at the hole I'm in. She got the kitty, left me a mule to ride. She got the kitty, left me a mule to ride. She got the kitty, left me a mule to ride. The train left the station, I pulled in behind. When I'm crazy about her, that hard-headed woman of mine. When I'm crazy about her, that hard-headed woman of mine. Crazy about her, that hard-headed woman am I.
So tomorrow, Jason's doing a friend show, and the friend is going to be Graham Lesch. And we're using a little bit different technique than yesterday, so it should the audio should be much better. And when we do our next show with the T's and the rest of Full Moon Alice, we've got an idea for how to avoid the audio challenges of yesterday. But we are going to keep experimenting because, let's face it, we might be stuck here for a long time, and we're never going to learn anything if we don't try some stuff. And the advantage of doing this every day is that, you know, you learn something every day. And one of the key questions is, how does this sound? Because if this sounds better, we can do this for both Jason and me, and we can do it for everybody else too. We just gotta, you know, we gotta know what works, and we gotta know what doesn't. But we watched yesterday's show on replay afterwards, and was like, okay. I mean, it's too bad, because the T's sounded amazing, and just, you couldn't hear them on the, anyway, doesn't matter.
Riding on the city of New Orleans, Illinois Central, Monday morning rail. 15 cars and 15 restless riders, 3 conductors and 25 sacks of mail. All along the southbound Odyssey, the train pulls out of Kankakee, rolls on past houses, barns, and fields, passing towns that have no name, freight yards full of old black men, the graveyards of the rusted automobile. Good morning, America, how are you? Say now, don't you know me? I'm your native son. I'm the train they call City of New Orleans. And I'll be gone 500 miles when the day is done. Playing cards with the old men in the club car. Hit a point, ain't no one keeping score. Pass the paper bag that holds a bottle. Feel the wheels rumbling beneath the floor. Sons of Pullman porters, sons of engineers, ride their father's magic carpet made of steel. Mothers with their babes asleep, rocking to that gentle beat. The rhythm of the rails is all they feel. Good morning, America, how are you? Say now, don't you know me? I'm your native son. I'm the train they call City of New Orleans. And I'll be gone 500 miles when the day is done. Nighttime on the City of New Orleans, changing cars in Memphis, Tennessee. Halfway home, we'll be there by morning. Through the Mississippi Delta down to the sea. All the towns and people see fade into a bad dream. steel rails, still ain't heard the news. The conductor sings his song again. The passengers will please refrain. This old train's got the disappearing railroad blues. Good morning, America, how are you? Say, now don't you know me? I'm your native son. I'm the train that calls the city of New Orleans. And I've been gone 500 miles when the day is done. Good night, America, how are you? Say, now don't you know me? I'm your native son. I'm the train that goes the city of New Orleans. And I'll be gone 500 miles when the day is done. And I'll be gone 500 miles when the day is done.
Trains. They really are amazing, and it's too bad that we don't appreciate them in this country. For most of the world, trains are the way people get around, and it would be possible for trains in this country to be so awesome. And maybe that's one of the things we'll figure out after this pandemic, that, you know, part of having a clean earth and a great new economic policy will be, you know, adopting and embracing mass transit in ways that seemed very foreign to us as a country not so long ago, but which are, you know, dead easy to do everywhere else. They're kind of standard. Anyway, one of the cool things, of course, is the master himself wrote train songs, and I'm going to play one.
Ride that mail train, can't buy through. Well, I've been up all night, babe, leaning on a windowsill. And if I die on top of the hill, well, if I don't make it, you know my baby will. Well, don't the moon look good, mama, shining down through the trees? The brakeman look good, mama, flagging down the double E. Well, don't the sun look good, setting down over the sea? Oh, my gal look fine when she's a-running off to me. The wintertime is coming, the windows are filled with frost. I tried to tell everybody, but I could not get across. I wanna be your lover, babe. Don't wanna be your boss. Well, don't say I didn't warn ya when your train gets lost. The wintertime is coming. Windows are filled with frost. I tried to tell everybody, but I could not get across. I wanna be your lover, babe. Don't wanna be your hall boss. Well, don't say I didn't want you when your train gets lost. Well, don't say I didn't want you when your train gets lost.
Not all train songs are serious, naturally. And not all of them are metaphorical. But this one, I don't know what this is.
Once upon a time there was an engineer. He drove his locomotive both far and near, accompanied by a monkey who would sit on his stoop, watching everything the engineer would pull. One day the engineer wanted a bite to eat. He left the monkey sitting on the driver's seat. The monkey pulled the throttle, locomotive jumped the gun. 90 miles an hour down the main line run. Big locomotive right on time. A big locomotive rolling down the line. Big locomotive number 99. Left the engineer with a worried mind. The engineer called up his dispatcher on the phone. He told him all about his locomotive was gone. Get on the wire switch operator to ride, cause the monkey's got the main line sewed up tight. Switch operator got the message in time, so there's a northbound limited on the same main line. Open up the switch, I'm gonna let him in the hole. The monkey's got the locomotive under control. A big locomotive right on time. Big locomotive rolling down the line. Big locomotive number 99. Left the engineer with a worried mind. Said big locomotive right on time. A big locomotive rolling down the line. Big locomotive number 99. Left the engineer with a worried mind. Said left the engineer with a worried mind. Said left the engineer with a worried mind.
Yes, the monkey and the engineer. I learned that from the Grateful Dead, as I learned many things. They played it in that 1980 run at the Warfield and at Radio City Music Hall. And I was lucky enough to attend one of those shows and heard it in person. And then it came out of the album. I learned the song from that. I don't even know who wrote it. Shame on me. But I know who wrote this one. This one was written by two guys, a guy named John and a guy named Paul. And I think it was written in like 1959, but it didn't appear in an album until 1970. And I've had the good fortune to see Paul play it a few times.
Then said, move over, honey, traveling on that line. Move over once, move over twice. Say, honey, don't be cold as ice. You know I'm traveling on the one after 909. I beg not to go, beg nor I'm a bended knee. Said, you fool around, you only fool around with me. Said, move over once, move over twice. Say, baby, don't be cold as ice. Say, you're traveling on a one after 909. Picked up my bags, ran to the station. Railman said, you got the wrong location. Picked up my bags, ran right home. Then I found I got the number wrong. said you're traveling on the 1F909. Said move over, honey, traveling on that line. Said move over once, move over twice. Said baby, don't be cold as ice. Said you're traveling on the 1F909. Picked up my bags, ran to the station. Rail man said, you got the wrong location. Picked up the bags, ran back home. Then I found I got the number wrong. One, baby said, travel, travel, not where I know nine. Said, move over, honey, traveling on that line. Said, move once, move twice. Said, baby, don't be cold as ice. Said you're traveling on the 1F909. Said you're traveling on the 1F909. Said you're traveling on the 1F909.
Well, all right. This has been a half duo show. I'm Roger McNamee. I hope the audio has been an upgrade. Let us know. Tomorrow Jason's doing his gig with Graham Lesh, and then Sunday the two of us will be back. If the reviews on this are good, we'll have two of these. Again, we're not using these like a regular mic, we're just using like an ambient mic to pick up the overall sound and give it a little boost. And then next week, Monday, I think, or Wednesday, I'm not sure which, we'll have the Tees back and maybe other Full Moon Owls band members. But we're going to be doing a lot of experimenting over the next few weeks because it's just fun to do that. Anyway, love you all. Again, please look out for all the people who are on the front lines. You know, there's a temptation to say they're heroes. I think the most important thing for us to do, I mean, they're clearly heroes, but they deserve to be paid better and they deserve to be treated with more respect. And if there's anything you can do to help with that kind of stuff, I hope you'll do it. You know, even if it's just giving them a tip when they drop stuff off for you or when they, you know, work the cash register for you at the grocery store. These are people whose jobs put them on the front line. And I think in order to make this whole experience work for a long period of time, we're going to have to find out a way of taking really good care of the people who work in medicine and the people who work in the various delivery services and grocery stores and pharmacies and the like, the police and fire. We've got to find a way. Because if you think about it, those people, I mean, people in hospitals are reasonably well paid, but for the risks that they're taking, I doubt they're paid well enough. And the rest of them, definitely not. And those poor people in the Amazon warehouses, I mean, today I think there was a strike by white-collar people at Amazon in sympathy for the folks in the warehouse. If that went off, that's a big deal. We'll have to check the news and see if it actually happened. Anyway, take care of yourselves, and we'll see you next time. Love you. Bye-bye.